train like you fight, and you'll fight like you train, the saying goes. And the Marines from the two Fleet Anti-Terrorism Security Teams from Hampton Roads take their training deadly seriously. They're deployed at any given time in Italy, Bahrain, and Japan, so they can quickly respond to world crises like the twin U.S. Embassy bombings in East Africa.
The flexibility, the responsiveness to meet emergency, whether it be through the reinforcement of naval installations or, in this case, the deployment of fast platoons into Africa, just to be ready and flexible at all times.
They constantly drill, practicing not only their marksmanship, but also skills they might need in situations like their fellow FAST team members now face in Africa. Skills like embassy protection and confronting terrorists up close and personal.
You can actually see the tactics work. You actually have aggressors and things like that to go against you. And it works very well, sir.
What you're going to do with the second hand, you put the palms so it covers.
And the training the FAST team members do here in Chesapeake is for professionals only. Ask 13 photographer Kevin Johnson.
It was a little harder than I thought. Those things look really small.
Fortunately, the U.S. has the pros to do the job. And what a job they do, says their boss.
The quality of young men that we have in this battalion, I believe, has been tremendous. They are the pride of America. I'm very proud of them.
They're fast, they're on the front line when duty calls. Mike Gooding, 13 News, Chesapeake.
To Navy ships, installations, and embassies. They prepare for duty at the Marine Corps' Northwest Training Area in Chesapeake. It's the basics in marksmanship, plus enhanced and close quarters training, which makes these rapid deployment platoons such an elite force.
In that way, we're really defensive in nature. What we hope to do is harden the target so that we would deter any potential terrorists that would look at the site as a potential target.
These FAST Company members may also be pressed into action to harden a site.
We go in to establish that initial footprint and protect the personnel, but if anything were to happen, then through the various skills that we're taught, we would be able to defuse that situation.
Whether it's eliminating a threat, securing a perimeter with the aid of specially trained bomb dogs and machine guns, or retrieving hostages, FAST teams stand ready as site security specialists in an ever-changing world theater.
Most scenarios and situations that we're encountering nowadays are in urban environments. So this is something that's much needed throughout the Marine Corps.
At the Northwest Training Area in Chesapeake, Paula Miller, News Channel 3.
Here in Hampton Roads, and they train in Chesapeake. Telling your side, Cy Bolton watched their training today. He joins us now from the newsroom with more. Cy?
Well, Les, they are called FAST teams, Fleet Anti-Terrorism Security Teams. Now, the two platoons that went to Africa were already deployed in the Med and the Persian Gulf. They are specially trained to provide security in high-threat situations.
Marines storm the building, then methodically disperse, searching for terrorists. In this close quarters battle drill, FAST team members fire only paint pellets, but it's great training for the anti-terrorism security they're called to perform overseas.
If an embassy gets taken over, you can send in FAST 1 or FAST 2 and go out there and just clear the building.
There are 11 FAST platoons in Hampton Roads, about 50 Marines in each. At any time, three platoons are deployed outside the U.S., two on alert here. They were formed in 1987. The number doubled early this year. All received sophisticated, realistic training in combating terrorism and providing security. On this day, however, the intensity has been magnified by the events in Africa.
It's a bad situation, I think, sir. I would be upset, you know, if something like that happened to someone close to me, and also, of course, because it happened to Americans, sir.
Now, while many of the extreme tactics out here aren't relative to the situation at the two embassies in Africa, much of what they learn out here is.
Like establishing a large, secure buffer zone around government installations during high-threat situations, and how to gather intelligence. Major Bill Smith commands the two platoons doing just that in Africa right now.
They're the eyes on the outside. They are responsible for the security of the building. Yes, some of that could be related to intelligence gathering because they have to be aware of what's going on out there at all times.
Now, FAST teams generally get little recognition, but their presence generally deters acts of aggression. They've been deployed to Albania, Liberia, Somalia, Cuba, and Panama, so they've been around some hostile situations. Les and Carolyn,